What's up, interview hackers? Sam here from ByteByByte.com, and today I want to talk about something really interesting. I want to talk about the idea of using progressive overload to get better at coding interviews, to get to the point where you go into your coding interview and you say, wow, that was easy. Because think about it, if you are in the position where you can go into your interview and when they ask you a question, you find that question actually easy to solve, that's gonna totally change the game for you when you go into your coding interviews. Because when you feel confident in your ability to solve the problem, when you go and you see the problem and you're like, oh, I got this. Think about how that changes your mentality. If you can shift your mentality from being stressed out, being scared that you aren't gonna be able to solve the problem to being confident and being prepared and being like, I totally am gonna crush this, it changes everything. And so I wanna show you how to do this. And to do this today, we're gonna talk about this idea of progressive overload. And this is actually a concept that I'm stealing from health and fitness and exercise, where generally speaking, if you wanna get stronger, you use this idea of continuing to push yourself beyond your limits. So the idea behind progressive overload is that one day I'm gonna go work out and maybe I do 10 bicep curls with a 10 pound dumbbell. And then the next day what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add more weight and I'm gonna continue over time as I get stronger, I'm gonna keep pushing to increase the weight or increase the reps or just generally increase the amount of work I'm doing because that's what is going to allow me to get stronger. If I continue to say, okay, every day for the next 10 years, I'm gonna go into the gym and I'm gonna do 10 bicep curls with a 10 pound dumbbell, then I'm not gonna make a whole lot of progress, right? I'm gonna stay static. And the same is true with our coding interviews. And so I wanna show you how to do this when you are actually preparing. Because what I see most people do is they'll go on LeetCode, they'll go wherever, and they're just gonna pick random practice problems. They're like, I'm gonna practice this, I'm gonna try to solve a practice problem, and they're either gonna be successful at solving it or they're not. But that doesn't actually then, depending on the result there, they don't actually change the way that they are approaching their interview prep. They just keep going in that same direction. They keep solving those same problems. They keep taking the same approaches. And that's really not a very strategic approach. That's not a strategic way to do this. And as an interview hacker, you really want to think about how can I do this strategically? And so what we want to think about doing is how can we apply progressive overload? How can we apply this idea of getting progressively harder and progressively increasing the resistance or the difficulty as we go. So the way that I would recommend that you prepare for your interviews, that you prepare specifically in terms of practice problems, is that you start with easy problems and you work up from there. So it's really important that you start with easier problems because think about it, I'm gonna keep coming back to this fitness example here, but if you went into the gym and you tried to say, okay, well, I'm just gonna start with, you know, a 100 pound dumbbell curl. You're gonna go in, you're gonna maybe lift up the weight and you're like not actually gonna be able to do anything, right? It's gonna be too heavy and so you're not actually gonna see any results. And so what you wanna do is you wanna start easier than your limit, right? You wanna start at that area where you can actually do the work and then work your way up until you start to reach that failure point, until you start to reach the point where, in the case of the coding interviews, you were able to solve those easy problems and now they're getting to the point where they're too hard. If you start with saying, I'm gonna go for a super hard problem on LeetCode and you have no idea what to do, that doesn't actually help you progress. It doesn't actually help you improve because you're not actually solving the problem. And so what you wanna do is you wanna start easy and then you wanna push so that you're always on that boundary. You always wanna be on that boundary where the problem is a little bit too hard for you, but with time you can solve it. Because if you're on that boundary, it's continually pushing you to improve. It's continually pushing you to get slightly better to actually be able to solve that problem. It's not impossible. It's not a problem that you have no idea how to solve, but maybe it's taking you an hour, maybe it's taking you 2 hours. And then the idea is that as you keep pushing, as you keep getting better, once you go into your interview, you're gonna realize, wow, that problem was actually really easy because you've been continually progressing. You've been continually pushing yourself to solve harder and harder problems. And so that's the general idea behind this. And I wanna give you a couple specific pointers with this to make sure that you're getting the most value out of this strategy, because while it works, it can also be somewhat demoralizing. And I think this is the key thing. I actually got an email from a student recently who is basically saying that, you know, he goes and tries to solve hard problems on LeetCode, and while he's able to do it or make progress after a couple hours, he finds it really demoralizing because he's like, there's no way that I would be able to do this in the context of the interview. And he's right. That's the thing, right? Is he's not wrong that if it's taking him 2 hours to solve the problem, that would not be good enough for an interview. But the good thing is that he is getting that experience solving problems that are likely harder than any problems that he would actually have to solve in his interview. And so by working on these harder problems, he's going to go into the interview and find it easy. And if you're doing this properly, you are constantly going to feel like you are in that state where you don't know what the heck you're doing. Right? Because if you get to the point where you're solving interview questions and they're easy, or you're solving them and you're like, wow, like I totally got this, then that means that you're not actually pushing yourself hard enough. And so this is the weird thing. It can be kind of mess with your brain because you're constantly pushing yourself to do better and better and better. And so you're never actually good at what you're doing. Because as soon as you're halfway decent, you're pushing yourself to do even more. You're going even harder. But then what you realize is it's super important to take stock in where you are and how you've progressed, because then you go back and you're like, wow, all this other stuff that I used to think was hard is now super easy. And so that's the idea here behind progressive overload. You're continuing to make your life more difficult. You're continuing to work on harder and harder problems as you get better and better. And it's allowing you to basically increase your baseline, increase the level of what you think is hard, so that now the things that you thought were hard before are actually easy. And if you continue to do this, then you're going to be able to go into your coding interviews and you're going to be like, wow, that was really easy. And so with that, I think this is a really useful technique you can use. I'd highly encourage you to try this out. Let me know what your experience is like as you're applying this. And with that, that's all I got for you today. If you enjoyed this video, definitely make sure you go over to bytebybyte.com/50questions to check out our free 50 coding interview questions guide. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.